Well, another big bank and another big profit. We're going over to Mike Eppel with the details on that. Hello.
Yeah, good morning, Melanie. CIBC in with its third quarter earnings update this morning. And a profit of just over $1 billion, $1.1 billion in earnings to be exact for the Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce, which was actually down a little bit compared to last year. But again, you look at these numbers year to year and there's always factors at play, whether it's accounting charges or purchases or asset sales. You look at the revenue, though, they're steady, and the CIBC, if you're an investor in the company, and most people are, if you have an RRSP with Canadian Holdings, the bank stocks are pretty influential, and they're paying out more to shareholders as of today, with the dividend payment going up by a couple of percentage points. So some pretty good numbers there. The CIBC's mortgage book, mortgage holdings, also up 13% in the latest quarter, which is the biggest increase in mortgage holdings for the big bank since 2007. So an interesting number there. Yesterday, the head of the Royal Bank of Canada, which also reported strong earnings, CEO Dave McKay was talking about the recent rule changes for the Ontario mortgage market or real estate market, and Vancouver says there still might need to be some tweaks in all of that to still cool things down just a little bit, and they're monitoring that situation. We've got an interest rate policy watch today because all of the central bankers of the world are gathering in the resort community of Jackson Hole, Wyoming, talking about interest rates and monetary policy and the thinking that later this year they're going to start pulling back on economic stimulus. That is something to watch. We've had the Bank of Canada, of course, this year raise interest rates, as has the U.S. Central Bank, and all of this plays itself out in the market, whether it's stocks or currencies or bonds. So again, could be some market events there with Janet Yellen, the head of the U.S. Central Bank, set to speak today. Despite internal company turmoil, Uber is seeing a big increase in its quarterly sales and number of people taking Uber taxi cabs. We've got revenue at the company up 17% according to internal documents. They didn't lose as much money. Uber's market value, if it were to go public, would be worth about $65 billion. We're also on storm watch, Tropical Storm Harvey heading toward the Gulf of Mexico. That could affect the price for oil into next week. If it turns into a hurricane, would be the first hurricane to hit Texas since 2008. Price for oil could see on that, and the Canadian dollar starts close to 80 cents U.S.